just right now shift your focus. You're not looking at what's going on around you. You're not looking at who's still walking into the sanctuary. You're not thinking about what song are they going to sing or how much money's in my bank account right now. Sorry if I reminded you of some of that. But we're going to shift our focus right now. We're only going to look at Him. Thank you, Jesus. We're only looking at you, Jesus. Right now and always, you're the only thing that matters. Thank you, Jesus. So right now, we fix our eyes on the prize. We only want to see your face. We only want to hear your voice. We block out everything else. Anything that doesn't ring with the spirit of truth is not of you. And so, God, we hone in, we focus in on only the spirit of truth. What you speak over us, what you say over us, what you think about us, God. Because your thoughts are higher than our thoughts. Your ways are higher than our ways. Thank you, Jesus. God, we long to encounter you today in a real way. When we walk out of here today, we want to be able to say we are changed. And that does not hinge upon you because you're already here, God. It hinges upon what we do in this moment. Whether we're willing to sacrifice, whether we're willing to press in, whether we're willing to lay down the hard things to lay down. So God, right now, I pray that you would make us pliable in your presence, God. That you would make us soft. That you would be able to mold us, Lord God. That we would listen, that we would not have stony hearts, God, but we would listen. We would have spiritual ears right now to hear what you have to say and spiritual hearts to accept those things in Jesus' name we pray this. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
My soul longs for you, 'cause nothing is.
bucket that's out there. Do any of you guys know what I'm talking about? So if you see these mud bucket trucks coming down the road, just ready to get on there, everybody's got a big smile on their face, they just can't wait. When that rain comes in, sometimes it makes things a little messy, right? But if you've been in a drought for very long, you welcome that.
Rush the Lord,
because you can find yourself in an even bigger waiting period. waiting on what He actually has for you. So make sure this morning that you've heard from the Lord, that you understand what boxes He wants to check off, that you understand what parameters He sees for whatever this is, this decision in your life this morning. He's in the waiting, and He'll be there when it's right, when it's His time. We thank you, Jesus.
Time.
Can you see that promise? I'm sorry. Amen. But I feel like I need to share this with you today. When we were in Evansville last week, there was a mama who had just been told by the doctors that her son's brain wasn't fully formed. And that there were other things that they could see on the different tests that they were doing that showed them that he was not going to be fully functioning. And this baby, judging by the size of the baby, I would say he was getting to be about 7 or 8 months old at this point. And he was starting to exhibit that. When you looked at a child, you could tell that there were things that weren't quite right. And as soon as they brought this baby up, I had a church. It's not even my home church. It's a great big assembly, big old platform. You know, and they've got all these people that are designated to do this. But God said, you've got to go talk to that mom. You have to go tell her about that. You have to tell her that you had a baby, that his brain wasn't fully formed, that you had a baby that was supposed to be severely mentally handicapped, and that God is never failing, and he will do it. In fact, I think Frank laid hands on somebody too in there. That got healed. So we were all over the place. But anyways, I went to that mama, and as soon as I got to her, when you know, there was just, the second I started to get to her seat, there was a swarm of people around her. And these women were sweet. They just wanted to love on her. Some of them just wanted to touch the baby and just love on the mama. But you could tell it was almost an agitation in that mom, like, just leave me alone right now. And I thought, God, I don't want to further bother her in this moment. You could just see the despair on her face, even though they had just prayed. But I waited patiently until they all left. And I reached out and I touched the mom. I didn't touch her baby, I touched the mama. Because in that moment, what was most important was her faith. Because this was going to be something that God wanted to do in her too, amen. So I touched her knee and I said, I know you don't know me. And I said, but I have to tell you. And I began to tell her just a brief little bit of Thane's story. And I said, it may not happen when you think it's going to happen. It may not look like you think it's going to look. But I am telling you right now that God has done it. And he will do it again. And she just began to pray and to weep. So whenever I sing this song and we begin to say, he's never failing, I sing that out of the very depths of my soul, out of the very depths of my spirit. And I pour that out over you this morning. And I pray that God would stir up hope and faith in you that he's done it before. And he will do it. want you to keep your promise before the Lord. This entire service.